as an individual and build a brand and make money off Instagram, off Facebook, and off Twitter. You need streams of income. One income cannot help anyone anymore, especially in the country we live right now. You should think because of you have a shoe brand and that is what you make and that's where your money comes every month. I am here to be the prophet that will tell you that will not sustain you anymore. You need to have another stream of income that can help you sustain this particular one. And how to do that is to know that branding is not just for your business. Branding that you're doing shouldn't be just for the business that you own. It should also be for you. Let me give you an instance. If you tell me you sell food, and I know as a normal person that you're a very dirty person, very dirty individual, I won't buy your food. So, I know you are the CEO of Kitchen International, blah, 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 blah. You put the name, you know that. But you are not a clean person. Nobody will patronize you. And this is why most businesses fail. They fail because people associate. That's one wrong side about entrepreneurship. Because when you own a business, the first thing you sell is you. Before people look at what you do. The first set of business is that you sell to people around you. It's the people around you are the first primary sellers that you sell to before the next set of people. So if I come and I know you, because we're now friends, and I see you and say you're into cake and restaurant, the first time you gave me cake and I tested it and I didn't like it, you know that the second time I won't buy it, right? And this is because I'm even a stranger. Now what happens is this. Someone comes and says, Jasmine, please, I need a cake person. I am a stranger. We are not family friends. Now what happens is that I look at the person that gave me a cake, and because I didn't like it, I'm not going to even mention it at all. Now this is based on your business. But you know that those first foundation people that know you and they love you and they're your friends and your family, when people ask them, what they're going to check is, oh, I know this person. When Aunt B was mixing that cake, and she was using things that I don't know. I'm not going to. They don't mention it. Because they already know you in and out. They know how you use your equipment. They know how passionate you are about your business. Whether it's good or bad, they already know. You know what will happen is that they will not patronize and they will not go to tell people about your business. Because they've seen that you do not care about the ingredients you use in your business. They think, okay, that this person do not promote their business as they tell the whole world that they do. So because of that, I'm not even going to bother to reach out to them. So the first thing you're going to do, if you know you want to go into business, is to brand yourself. So how do you brand yourself? What are the benefits of branding yourself? Now, everyone has a brand. However, only a few people manage to turn their brands into a strength. We all have a brand. We all have passion for what you want to go into, what you have passion for. Some of us are into farming, but what we love talking about is football. Some of us are into sales of hair, but what we actually have passion is making up. Some of us are students, but what we have very good passion about is maybe talking to people about increasing their sales. Now, that is where you're going to make your stream of income. I'm going to use myself as an example. So, I run a business called Arinze Media, and we do events, and we do digital marketing, and all that. Now, I know that I love food. I mean, this is different from the business I run, right? So I go out and I meet with people and we are taking drinks. I take a picture and I post it up. There's a wedding that's going on somewhere and the food looks nice. Oh, I take a picture and I put it up on my Facebook. And I say, you know, two times people come there and say, oh, this girl, you like to eat. And I laugh. Oh, thank you very much. This girl, you get back to. And I go, until one day, I think I was doing just a normal thing. One day, I got a message. And I said, oh, Nazi, we like what you're doing, but there's something we want you to do for us. Can you put up something on your page for us? I said, yes, no problem, I can do that. They sent me the flyers I'm posting on. And people are commenting on what I posted. Oh, that this food, this is not how they cook food. Who is cooking this food? This is not how we go to make our bacha. This is not how they do it. People are shouting. I was scared because somebody gave me the flyers to post, right? And if you come under the comment and people are bashing it, you feel like you're not doing a good job. cannot delay them. Like, I'm so new that these people are promoting this thing. But forgive them. She said, no, that is what they are looking for. What we call that is engagement. Say engagement.
Engagement.
You know how people come under your comment section and they are fighting. You know some people are making money from you fighting. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What's the popular blog you know? Where's your popular blog? Jesus love my Insta blog. Let me tell you guys how they make money. So you come and you see Insta blog posted, this number posted about social media and this one, what they're doing and that one. Then you carry yourself. You come on that day and you write, ha, this don't they took a Jew. Someone that likes something around me that says, you sell it took a Jew, this don't out of it. You tell yourself from that time. You know that thing you're doing is increasing traffic for them. Now what happens is that an advert will come because they know that people are on this page. People are always commenting on this page. Brands, what do brands need? Visibility. So since brands are looking for visibility, they will go to G-Stopper and say, G-Stopper, you know all those fights that people are fighting? He wants you to post this thing. Now G-Stopper will now charge me. That's how I was doing that thing. And the lady said, no, don't worry, this is what we need. That was my first introduction to what we call influencer marketing.
Together as a welcome present to the program. I'm going to be focusing on branding and storytelling. I've done branding and storytelling for 7 years. Most of the time when you saw those need campaigns, you gotta restart your name. I was actually on that campaign. I actually work for Blueprint Africa. So, but let me not go to that place. I'm going to focus on branding because at the end of the day, people want to set up businesses, right? People want their business to stand out. People want their business to go up. People want to build a business that is so strong. But at the end of the day, they make mistakes, and those mistakes are the reason why most of the businesses don't scale. If I ask somebody, oh, let me brand your business or brand your business, the first thing that comes to their mind is, I want a logo. I want ID card, I want a headed paper, I want a name. But at the end of the day, if you actually need to brand your company to actually stand out, that is actually not even on the list of the first 10 things you should do. What's that? People think branding is physical, but branding is emotion. Branding is perception. Branding is how people feel about your product. Branding is how people feel the emotion, the image, like you have created in their hearts. Then when it comes to all those logo designs and all, those ones are things that help in identifying your brand. By the end of the day, the main work of branding is how you make it feel. For example, I use an iPhone, right? And 80% of the reason, you know, a lot of my friends DJ use Apple laptop, right? My class is going to be more important. I want you to understand this. I keep time. I'm not talking today. I'm a storyteller, literally. I can come here and tell you 50 million stories of people that make money. But today, I'm teaching. Like, normal teaching will ask questions to understand it. Because at the end of the day, we need to actually start raising people who understand what branding means. We need to start building companies in this that will actually help and actually bring investors. You find out big companies have this unique logo that is adaptive. Just see it to understand it. Do you know that one of the biggest people who are paid in graphics are people who design company logos, not some people who do flyers? Because the logo is the image of the brand. But do you know where a lot of people do? We call a graphic designer. Now, if that's our logo, if the event and so on, it will only be one or two things. First of all, you are still feeding your brand. Or you want to choose a color for your business and you now come and say, my color is green and white. Use it. You have stepped in your business. Every single thing in branding has a process as where you are going to achieve, where you are going to get to before you start choosing colors. For example, people who do children wear understand that they have peculiar colors that are attractive to children. So you don't come and say because my color is red, then I come and impose it on them. You have started killing your business. Every single brand has a personality. Brands like Benz, Apple, a whole lot of them understand it. There's something called the brand voice. When your brand is speaking, people understand you. I connect to this brand. Because every single thing you have to do in terms of branding is emotional. Don't let anybody deceive you. Branding is emotional. Branding is perception. The fastest way to kill your business or your brand is when you start thinking you are selling to everybody. You cannot sell to everybody. You just find the people, your niche, and the people that appeal to you, and the people you are creating for, and you find a way to create a perception in their mind, and you find a way to sell to them. So the strongest thing you need to take out from here today is, there is no brand that is for everybody. Benz is not selling to everybody, hope you know. Because you're making money, because the maintenance fee, you can send it to the village. See this word, research. A lot of people don't. You know what we do? My friend owns a jewelry shop and she's making money. Piam! You are in that line. And that she's making money. The whole of New York is selling food now. And see what happens. 3-4 months, that person leaves. And that person comes to say, oh, you know that place, there's a new spot. Bam, they replace. Because we don't research. You should never, before you even think of, before you even think of saying I want to do something, you should actually focus on the word research. The internet is there for you.
Hey, my name is Arinze Chilo-Offiah. I'm the Special Advisor on SME Development and also the Director General of the Enugu SME Center. And today, this is our fourth edition of the Enugu Skills Acquisition Masterclass. We've had programs in fashion, financial literacy. Today we're having a content creation. So we had these two individuals that are big social media influencers, and they've told them their secrets on how they can get into this burgeoning digital space. You know, social media promotions, being an influencer and making money through your content is something that is very big for this generation, especially the younger generation, as a means of making some funds, as a means of making some funds, or as a means of producing some value of wealth for themselves. So we are pleased to host this event. We're going to put them in focus groups and to be able to provide them additional training, book up pieces. So this is something we are quite excited about. We also want to thank our working governor, Right Honourable Ifeanyi Ogunwanyi, for his continued support for the Enugu SME Center.
My name is Opa Fochidera Precious. I'm a student entrepreneur. I attended this seminar to try to monetize my social media, and actually I've learned a lot about monetizing my business brand and also trying to build me as a brand and trying to make my brand not just be a thing but also a personality. It's not just about the logo and the name or whatever, but have to create a perception in people's minds. So this seminar has really been a lot for me, and it has helped me to learn new things on how to make good use of my social media platform. So I want to thank the governor and the special advisor, the governor.
Good day, my name is Henry Onwemu. I got this invite from Instagram and I decided to come for it. I learned a lot from this program, which was hosted by Honorable Arinze Chilo-Offiah. I learned a lot, like networking, how to brand your business, and a lot of. So I just want to thank the organizers that they should keep doing it, actually helping small businesses.
I want to thank the governor of Enugu State for the opportunity given to us to attend this program, and this SA on SME, Honorable Chilo-Offiah. We learned a lot today. I learned a lot about using social media to influence my brand, about branding and everything that I need in order to improve my business. I want to thank them in a special way for organizing the use of this for giving us a platform to learn and to upgrade our